Jesselyn just said that the war on whistleblowers is a backdoor war on journalists. And that's something that should get everyone pause, because oftentimes there is a debate between the role that journalists should actually play in advocating for themselves. It's not only that they need to advocate for themselves, but also they need to advocate for the sources and the networks that they rely upon to do their work. And in this case, we saw the New York Times and other news organizations hiring a team of lawyers to defend James Risen against the subpoena for his sources. But they didn't do much more to protest the prosecution of Jeffrey Sterling or the severe punishment that was meted out. And so Free Press is an organization that works on advocacy on these issues. And as advocates, we like to think of people in our sphere as what people, why people, and how people. What people often are people like Jeffrey Sterling or like Edward Snowden, who first alert people to a problem. The why people might be people like Glenn Greenwald or the filmmaker Laura Poitras, who actually have a history of analysis, and they explain why a problem like this is important to our society. And the how people, or organizations such as ours, such as Reporters Without Borders, such as ACLU, such as EFF, who try to figure out how to solve that problem. The problem that we're seeing in the world of journalism right now is that it's peopled with what and why people. And yet there is an aversion to this idea that they need to advocate to be how people, to actually try to solve problems. And that comes out of one of the fundamental tenets of journalism, being an objective reporter means you're not an advocate. And so one of the things that we're advocating for is getting journalists more engaged in this case. And of course, this is a fundamental problem, not only for journalists, but for everyone who is in their sort of information ecosystem. And it's become very, very problematic in the era of the Obama administration. The Obama administration is like the Nixon administration in many respects. The Nixon administration tried to silence whistleblowers using illegal means. But the Obama administration is trying to silence whistleblowers using a misinterpretation of the laws that are on the books. And they have done it to greater impact than Nixon could ever imagine. 8 whistleblowers have been prosecuted in this administration. That's more than any presidential administration prior to Obama. The work of advocates needs to focus on the types of laws that this administration is using, because certainly they are setting a precedent for future administrations. The Espionage Act, which was used against Jeffrey Sterling, is an outdated law. It was written in 1917. It was designed to be used against World War I era saboteurs and communists, and has been misinterpreted by this administration with very dangerous impact on journalists and sources. There needs to be an effort to repeal the Espionage Act, to amend it. But it's not the only tool that's in the arsenal of the Obama administration. The Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, which was written in 1986, well before the internet became popularly available, has been used by this administration to prosecute people whom, for lack of a better term, we call hackers. Oftentimes, there are hackers who break into systems and do things that are illegal, but there are also hackers who are doing things for social benefit. One of those, Aaron Swartz, faced U.S. prosecution under the CFAA, the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, and was hounded so severely by U.S. prosecutors in Boston that he ultimately decided, and tragically decided, to end his life. As we look at what's happened to Jeffrey Sterling, we need to look at the works that journalists need to do. Journalists need to not only advocate for themselves, which they did a very good job, the New York Times and other organizations advocating for James Risen, but they need to advocate for everyone that exists within their ecosystem of information. That includes sources, That includes whistleblowers. They also need to advocate for keeping networks open against incursions to our privacy. This administration has looked at some of the legislation that was passed in the wake of the September 11th attacks, and is considering amending some of the privacy legislation under the Patriot Act, under the FISA Amendment Act. It would also be very helpful to journalists. So really, this is, in a way, a call to arms for journalists to get more engaged with those advocates who are doing the good work defending whistleblowers, and to make this their own cause, and to join this fight and make sure that we get not only a pardon for Jeffrey Sterling, but also we change the laws that are being misinterpreted and abused to this end. Thank you.